Yes, today I'm talking about physics, but relax and follow me. I'm not starting writing equations or explaining you physical laws. Instead, I would like to start with a question, a simple question actually. If I could ask any of you the question, what do you see on the screen? I think he would most likely answer, well, I see a man with a mustache and a hat. Okay, I would answer that too. But wait a second and continue looking at the screen. What do you see now? You still see the man? I personally see an adorable puppy with a bow. But this is exactly the same picture as before, just rotated. It's all a matter of perspective. This was just an illusion, an example, to show you that perspectives are fundamental. Because they can change our vision, or better, understanding of the world. Now, here it is something that Richard Feynman, an amazing and brilliant physicist, once said to his students. Imagine to be on shore and look at the sea. You can see the water, the waves breaking, the foam, the sand, the sky, the colors. You can feel the air, the little breeze on your skin. There are animals, there is sand, rocks, so various hardness, color, and texture. Perhaps there are other observers on the beach. They may be even happiness and thought. When watching a sunset, every one of us feels, experiences something different. And I like to share with you what I see when I watch a sunset. Where many people see the breeze and the waves, I see convective motion and energy transfer. Where someone tells me, whoa, look at those beautiful colors, I say, whoa, look at the amazing results of diffusion. Or better, I don't say it. I could be accused of spoiling the poetry of the sunset, so just think it. But anyway, the point is that studying physics made me see the sunset in a different way. Actually, physics made me see the world, not just the sunsets, in a different way, from a different perspective. And do you remember what we just learned about perspective from the illusions? Perspective changes our understanding. And if perspective matters when watching a sunset or an illusion, what about them if we are tackling global challenges such as global warming, diseases, poverty, energy supply, pandemics? If we are facing these issues, we have to keep in mind that singular academic perspective fails. We desperately need to face contemporary issues from different perspectives because each of them can give a positive contribution to our understanding and to a possible solution. And also, physics contributes to provide a perspective that helps dealing with today's challenges. Most of you are probably thinking, really? You, physicist, or better, aspiring physicist, not a physicist yet, you love to look for exotic things like dark matter, and you find particle collisions interesting and fun. How is this related to today's big challenges? I'm showing you how. Just follow me in these examples. Let's do an experiment of imagination. Imagine not to be on a shore this time. Imagine not knowing something, maybe the beginning hour of today's TEDx event. What would you do? I would probably do this, www.tedxsapienzaU.com. Maybe you ignored it every time you type on your browser, www. You're using something that was born in one of the biggest physics laboratories in the world. It was 1989 that a British scientist working at CERN, actually distressed by the difficulty of keeping track of all information of the research projects, invented the World Wide Web more or less as an act of desperation. But now imagine something different, or better. Look at this number. This is a very sad and painful number. 1,955,231 deaths caused by cancer in Europe in 2020. Now imagine to have something, to have a technology that allows to reduce this number. We actually have it. It is called positron emission tomography, and or PET. It was developed at CERN too, and it is one of the most used diagnostic methods for detecting tumors. And it uses antimatter, which is something that physicists discovered and learned to create. Bananas? Why are there bananas? Because even though the word antimatter may sound strange, every one of you knows a natural source of antimatter, which are bananas, actually. But now, last time, I promise, imagine that suddenly our energy supplies could no longer be available. Unfortunately, it isn't hard to do, given the unspeakable situation we are living. But now, imagine to have a bright candidate for serving mankind's energy needs. We may have something. We have a candidate the physicists are studying and examining. It is called the nuclear fusion. And nuclear fusion, the process by which light atomic nuclei react with each other to release energy, may be a clean and virtually limitless energy source that could power the future. But these were just proofs to show you that physics perspective can contribute to deal with today's challenges. If there's something from this speech I'd like you to walk away with, is that at the time of their inception, things like the World Wide Web or antimatter were viewed just as physicists' business. Now, they pervade our life, technology, medicine, so deeply that no one would question their practical importance. Why? Because physics provides the seeds for future technological developments. But not only do physics advancements push the frontier of technology. Here's another way physics, the perspective provided by physics is contributing to deal with contemporary issues. We live in a world that is data rich. And this large amount of data needs mathematical and physics tools to be interpreted. Modeling is something physicists are very good at. One of the primary goals of physics is to create mathematical models that allow both explanation and predictions of physical phenomena. And so now it begins the exciting journey from data to a possible model, which gives them a meaning. And I assure you that this is not a safe trip. It isn't linear at all. It's a complex, winding road featured by enthusiasm, clarity, confusion and doubts at the same time, but above all, passion and achievements and successes. It is not a case that, for example, two founding fathers of climate modeling were awarded with the Nobel Prize in Physics this year. Humans don't know the full impact they're having on the planet, but we do know a lot about the physics of the atmosphere, about carbon cycles, water cycles, something about weather. And using this information and how these cycles interact, physicists and other scientists are trying to figure out what might happen. After they define the problem, they make assumptions, then they define variables. Once they define variables, these variables tell how the equations will be like. And once physicists finally get to the equations, they will begin staring at them as if pondering one of Mark Rothko paintings. Sorry, as you can see, the slides aren't going, so... one of Mark Rothko paintings. Why? Because equations are works of art indeed. They're concise, impressive, elegant, living. They show us, they reveal us unexpected connections. For example, I could show you the connection between a population of rabbits, a dripping faucet, thermal convection in a fluid, the spread of a pandemic, and economic cycles with just one simple equation. You may not be amazed by the beauty of equations as I am, or be impressed by their power, but you can appreciate the ideas behind them, and you can feel the story of people who conceived them. But once we have models, how can they be useful? Good models have high predictive capabilities. They show us different what-if scenarios, giving us insights into the impacts of our choices. But if we want to change something, we must to avoid, or better, if we want to avoid consequent threats, we must act. Actions will shape our future. So I don't know how the future will be like. I have hopes, dreams, fears too. But during these 13 minutes, more or less, while I was guiding you in seeing simple things like the sunset or big challenges from the perspective provided by physics, I showed you our best window into the future, which is modeling. And I brought you in some of the places where this future is being written. Thank you.